Welcome students. Today we will learn about break-even analysis. So let us understand what is the meaning of break-even analysis. The break-even point is the point at which the total cost and total revenue are equal, that is even. There is no net loss or gain and one has broken even through the opportunity cost have been paid and capital has received the risk-adjusted expected return. In sensitivity analysis, we ask what will happen to the project if sales decline or cost increases or something else happens. As a finance manager, you will also be interested in knowing how much should be produced and sold at a minimum to ensure that the project does not lose money. Such an exercise is called as break-even analysis, and the minimum quantity at which loss is avoided is called as the break-even point. This break-even point may be defined in two different terms, that is accounting term of break-even and financial term of break-even. What is the main purpose of calculating the break-even point? The main purpose of break-even analysis or break-even point is to determine the minimum output that must be exceeded for a business to profit. It is also a rough indicator of the earnings impact of a marketing activity. A firm can analyze ideal output levels to be knowledgeable on the amount of sales and revenue that would meet and surpass the break-even point. If a business does not meet this level, it often becomes difficult to continue their operations. Break-even point is one of the simplest yet least used analytical tools. Identifying a break-even point helps provide a dynamic view of the relationships between sales, cost, and profit. What are the limitations of break-even analysis? The break-even analysis is only a supply side, that is cost-only analysis, as it tells you nothing about what sales are actually likely to be for the product at these various prices. Point number two, it assumes that the fixed costs are constant. Although there is true in short run, an increase in scale of production is likely to cause fixed costs to rise. Point number three, it assumes average variable costs are constant per unit of output, at least in the range of likely quantities of sales. Point number four, it assumes that the quantity of goods produced is equal to the quantity of goods sold. That is, there is no change in the quantity of goods held in inventory at the beginning of the period and the quantity of goods held in inventory at the end of the period. Point number five, in multiple product companies, it assumes that the relative proportion of each product sold and produced are constant. That is, the sales mix is constant. So these are some of the limitations of the break-even analysis. And let us solve a problem on break-even point from an accounting perspective as well as a financial perspective. So on the screen, you are able to see certain set of data which is provided of a particular company. Let us solve this particular problem from accounting perspective as well as financial perspective, and let us try to understand how this break-even point is arrived. So this is the set of data given, and what we have to solve is the break-even point from an accounting point of view and financial break-even point. So here is a solution that I have already solved. Let me explain you and take you through this particular solution. Okay, so to calculate accounting break-even point, the formula to calculate this accounting break-even point is fixed cost plus depreciation divided by contribution margin ratio. So here is the denominator, that is fixed cost plus depreciation. So fixed cost given in the problem you can see it here. The fixed cost given in the problem is 20 million and the depreciation given in the problem is 40 million. So 20 plus 40 will amount to 60 million. So fixed cost is 20 million and depreciation is 40 million. So both if you add together, this amounts to 60 million. So the next part is contribution margin ratio. So what is the formula to calculate the contribution margin ratio? So contribution margin ratio is equal to revenue minus variable cost divided by revenue. So if you just look at this 110, how we arrived at this particular 110 is very simple. So let us find out what is the revenue. So revenue is nothing but the sales figure. So revenue minus variable cost divided by revenue. So revenue is 440 minus variable cost is 330. So this will amount to 110. So 440 minus 330 is 110. So divided by 440, that is the revenue. So as per the formula, revenue minus variable cost divided by revenue. So this will amount to 0.25. So the 0.25 is the contribution margin ratio. So if you just look back at the formula of calculating the accounting break-even point is fixed cost plus depreciation divided by contribution margin ratio. So fixed cost plus depreciation is 60 million. So you can see here, and divided by the contribution margin value 0.25. So this will amount to rupees 240 million. So this is the accounting break-even point. Okay, so we will move on to the second part and let us try to understand the financial break-even point. So what you are seeing on the screen is the solution for the financial break-even point. So in the problem, you can just check the variable cost that is given is 75%. And the contribution margin ratio that we have calculated using the formula, that is contribution margin ratio is equal to revenue minus variable cost divided by revenue, is 25%. So this is the contribution margin ratio. And the fixed cost given in the problem is 20 million and the depreciation given in the problem is 40 million. So these four components are given in the problem. This is what we have calculated already. So basically, to understand, the three components are already available in the problem. These three components are available in the problem. And this is what we have calculated in the previous problem. So now our problem starts from pre-tax profit. So pre-tax profit is nothing but 0.25 into sales minus 60. So this 0.25 is nothing but the contribution margin. So that is 25%. Okay, so 25 divided by 100. So this will become 0.25. So here we have written 0.25 and this is multiplied by sales minus 60. 60 is nothing but 20 plus 40. Okay, so this will give us profit before tax. Why we have written sales here? Because we have to find out what is the break-even sales in this particular problem. So we have to identify this figure. So that is the reason. So this particular sales is unknown in this case. Okay. So pre-tax profit is equal to 0.25 into sales minus 60. So in the problem, you can see the tax rate is given. So that is 20%. So if you make it 20 divided by 100, so this becomes 0.2. So profit after tax is calculated as 1 minus 0.2 into 0.25 into sales minus 60. Okay, so this will be the profit after tax. 0.2, that is the tax rate given here. Okay, so 1 minus 0.2, that is the, if you remove 20% out of 100%, 80% what remains is the profit. This is the meaning of it. So that is the reason 1 is a constant, 1 minus 0.2 is a tax rate. So out of 1, if we remove 0.2, then what remains is 0.8. So 80% of this figure, whatever we get, is going to be our, this figure multiplied by 0.8 is going to be our profit after tax. Okay. So what is annual net cash flow? Okay. So annual net cash flow is profit after tax plus you are going to add back the depreciation component. So this 40 is the depreciation component. So for annual net cash flow, so this is the 80% profit plus this is the sales figure that we are going to calculate, and to this we are going to add back the depreciation. So this will give us our annual net cash flow. So if you just calculate these equation, we arrive at this particular figure. So that is, let me explain you, this is very simple to understand. So this is 0.8 multiplied by 0.25. So you get 0.2 sales. So 0.8 multiplied by 60 minus 40. So you will get, so here you will get 48. 48, this if you, both of these values, if you use a Bodmas rule and calculate, so this amounts to 48 minus 40. So this will amount to 8. So next one is present value of net cash flow. Now I have got the net cash flow over here. So if I want to take out the present value of this net cash flow, so present value of this net cash flow will be this 0.2 into sales minus 8 multiplied by present value interest factor annuity at 10% for 10 years. So this is the 10% is the cost of capital which is already given in the problem. So if you just look at the problem, the cost of capital given over here is 10%. So we are going to consider that 10%. Okay, so if I just look at the table and find out 10% for 10 years is 6.145. So multiply this. Okay, so whatever value that we get, present value that we get, we are going to deduct the initial investment. So if you just put it into equation, it appears something like this. Okay, so initial investment will come on this side, and the remaining quantity, this quantity will come on the other side. So if you just substitute the values and just try to calculate this particular problem, so the total value that you get is 365.47 million. That's all on break-even analysis. So thanks for watching this video. Please like, share and subscribe this channel. Thank you very much.